Hi children of 9th standard, how are you? Are you fine? Are you all safe staying at home? Are you all utilizing the holidays in a fruitful way? Shall we start the science class? Are you interested in learning science? Yes, take your science book. Before going to the first chapter, come to the contents page. In the contents page, you can see 15 chapters. Right from the chapter 1, matter in our surroundings, to chapter 15, improvement in food resources. This 15 chapters is divided into 5 themes. In your 10th standard also, it will be like that only. So, the board pattern, the 10th pattern and the 9th pattern is almost similar. So, learning properly in the 9th standard helps you to gain more marks in 10th standard. So this is very important. So learning science is very important in your life. Okay. Now, I already told you, know the 15 chapters is divided into 5 themes, or it is divided into 5 units. Okay. Let me explain one by one. Now, Chapter 1 and Chapter 2, Chapter 3, Chapter 4. So these 4 chapters are coming under the theme materials. These 4 chapters are coming under chemistry branch. Have you all noted? Yes, next one. Chapter 5, Chapter 6, Chapter 7, and Chapter 13. So these 4 chapters are coming under the second theme. Second theme is the world of living. They comes under biology. That is chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7 and chapter 13. So these 4 chapters are coming under the second unit, biology. Have you all understood, children? Then let's go for the third theme. Let us go for the third unit. In the third unit, we have 5 chapters. Chapter 8, chapter 9, chapter 10, chapter 11, chapter 12. So these 5 chapters are coming under the theme physics. That is, the theme is moving things, people and ideas. So these 5 chapters are coming under physics branch. This is a physics unit. Okay, have you all understood? Yes. Then the 4th theme is natural resources. In the 4th theme, there is only one chapter, natural resources. And the 5th theme is food resources. In the food resources, there is only one chapter, 15th chapter. Okay, so chapter 14 is coming under 4th theme and chapter 5 is coming under 5th theme. Have you all understood, children? Yes. Now, I am going to say how the mark is splitted up. You know that the board examination will be carried out for 80 marks, no? I already told you which belongs to physics, which belongs to chemistry, which belongs to biology and which belongs to EVS. Okay, you will be writing for 80 marks, isn't it? So, chemistry, that is chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. So, in these 4 chapters, you will be getting 23 marks out of 80. How many marks? You will be getting 23 marks out of 80 in your board examination. Have you understood, children? Yes. Then in biology, that is from chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7 and chapter 13. You will be getting 20 marks. So 20 marks will be from biology branch. Then chapter 8, chapter 9, chapter 10, chapter 11, chapter 12. So these 5 chapters belongs to physics, isn't it? So in this, 27 marks will be asked in board examination. Out of 80 marks, 27 marks will be asked in board examination. Have you all noted? Yes. Then in the 14th chapter, 6 marks will be asked for board examination. How many marks? 6 marks will be asked for board examination. Then in the 15th chapter, 4 marks will be asked for board examination. How many marks? 4 marks. So now I will sum up again. Okay. So chemistry 23 marks, biology 20 marks, then physics 27 marks, then EVS, natural resources 6 marks, then food resources 4 marks. Now count all the marks together. How many marks do you have? 80 marks. Like this only questions will be asked in your board examination. Before going to the class, you should know this. Have you all understood? Shall we start the first chapter, children? Yes, let us start the first chapter. Yes. Thank you, children. Let us start the first chapter in the next class.